If you're having trouble loading apps from the Google Play Store, trust me, you're not alone. New Nexus 7 tablets are already running into a lot of bugs, and investors sue Microsoft over the Surface RT. I'm Jaime Rivera, and let the record show that the reason why there are no iPhone 5C rumors in this video is because I'm bored of them. This is Pocket Now Daily. Let's start today off with the sort of official news, as Motorola's advisor Guy Kawasaki has just confirmed that they will be selling the Moto X on the Google Play Store. And the reason why this is odd is because for those of you that were expecting for there to be a Google edition of the Moto X, actually that's not necessarily going to be the case. Apparently there will only be the official Moto X being sold on the Google Play Store as another means to sell the phone, and not necessarily two different types of phones that you could choose from. Though obviously that is still not finally confirmed. Let's stay tuned, even though I'm sure none of you want to pay $650 for a Moto X anyways. Now, speaking of the Google Play Store, for those of you that are having this horrible issue of package file invalid every time you're trying to install an application on your tablet or phone, well, you're not alone. I'm having exactly the same problem on my first generation Nexus 7. And as it turns out, Google has just acknowledged that the problem exists, that they know that there is a problem in the Google Play Store, but the problem is they're not actually telling us when they're gonna fix it, so expect for there to be some sort of a fix eventually, though we're still not sure if that's hardware related or does it have to do with the Google Play Store, so stay tuned for that. And speaking of Nexus 7s, or at least the new generation tablet, well, the bad luck of early adopters continues, as people are already confirming that they have problems with their GPS, and they are also having problems with multi-touch on the tablet and pretty much makes it unusable in certain times. Google has also acknowledged that they know about this issue, but again, they're not confirming when they're going to fix it, so stay tuned, as if this is a software issue, they'll most probably send the patch sometime. Now, for those of you wondering why HTC is not bringing us any more compelling Windows phones as they have in previous years, well, kind of the reason for that is because apparently the company is backing away from the platform, according to trusted sources. And the reason why is because they feel that Nokia is doing a better job selling Windows phones, when actually the real truth is that Nokia is doing a better job building better differentiated Windows phones than HTC lately. Still, it's really hard to see that the manufacturer that pretty much started the whole Windows phone thing back in the days of the Pocket PC, HTC as an ODM, is moving away, but anyways, we'll see how that goes. And finally, for the sad news of the day, if you thought that losing Windows Phone OEMs was Microsoft's only problem, trust me, that's actually the smallest one. The company is being sued over the Surface, and the reason why is because, according to investors, the company knew well ahead that the tablet was not selling well and did not let investors know about the overstock until 3 months later. And obviously, there are lots of losses right there, and investors feel that they were cheated on with this whole Surface project, as the company probably overlooked how well that tablet was going to sell in the end. So anyways, we don't know how this is going to play out, but that leads me to the question of the day. What do you think that Microsoft should do with all these tablets that they have there in overstock? What do you think that they should do with them? In my particular case, I mean, if they're having trouble with people liking Windows RT or liking Windows 8, why not sell those things at $100 a piece, get the platform out there and get people to like them so that developers could jump on the wagon and build more applications for the Surface RT particularly? I think that's probably one of the best solutions. I mean, you're losing money anyways with the overstock. I mean, why not just make money somehow, at least not necessarily from the tablets? Leave us a comment down below. What do you think? Friends, you know the drill. If you want earlier news of everything that's happening in the smartphone and tablet world, make sure you follow us on PocketNow.com and subscribe to our YouTube channel as well. You can also follow me on Twitter at Jaime_Rivera. Please give this video a thumbs up if you like what you saw. I am Jaime Rivera. Thank you very much for watching. We will see you tomorrow.